Hello, glass fans. Today I'm making another octopus, but this one is going to be a pendant. Octopuses that are wearable pendants sit a lot flatter, and so all of their tentacles are flatter too. And then I just try to arrange them to fill up the circle, like a circular shape at the body will be the pendant. So I already pre-made the color rods that I'm going to be working with. These are the darkest cobalt blue 12mm, but I've already sort of given them stripes of blue moon frit and then coated them with 3 coats of clear frit, and then I pulled them down into something less than 12mm because octopus pendants are like also smaller and daintier than the figurine octos that sit themselves up. First, I'm going to make the head and the body. Then I'm going to gouge places for the eyes and put on the 2 legs first that are going to be the legs that the octopus hangs from a chain by. And then the next forward set of legs. Then I'm going to put on the eyes before I do the other 4 legs. The eyes of these pendants are made of clear, and they're quite large and bulbousy. I draw out some clear into something pretty thin, like maybe 2 or 3 millimeters. And then I just melt it until it stands up like a ball on the octopus's face. And then afterward, I try not to melt it flat into the octopus's face. It's working out pretty well. I think I have the hang of this. And we have the head and the body. Here I have, just like the process with the normal figurine octopuses, I've used my steel marble mold to create a sort of hourglass figure, which is the octo's head and neck and body. But unlike the regular figurines, this one's body has to be almost absolutely flat like a coin, and its head has to lean back more, and then immediately back up, and on either side of the head it's where the arms go that are going to be hanging on the chain. So now I've got to do some smushing. Oops. Little snafu here, and so I was getting another punty ready to stick onto the octo so that I could handle it from the other side when the almost hot new punty and the almost hot octopus, I accidentally touched them together and they get stuck. It's annoying and it happens all the time, and so I plinked them across my steel marble mold and then both punties came off. And now I have to heat these things back up and stick them back together the right way and proceed. Usually I handle these octopendants by the punty from their bottom, from the beginning. So now all I've got to do is flatten it out and then start sticking the legs on. These octopendants also go a lot faster than the octofigurines. I think I get one done in about two-thirds the time. Right now I'm flattening the head out behind the octopus body so that he'll sit nice and flat whenever he's done. But before we do the legs, let's put a little frit on his face. I still like them to have freckles. And we're gouging out a matching pair of eye sockets. Good lord, right? Well, I often have trouble getting these first two legs to, be even and look right once they're hanging. The rest of the legs come along with no trouble at all. It is time to do the eyeballs. So, the eyeballs are all bulbousy, but because the hot glass tends to retract itself into a ball, all I have to do is get the correct volume of glass in place, and then I just turn on the hot and it retracts into a perfect eyeball. Here goes nothing. Alright, so we only have one leg to go now. And then we'll position them up a little bit. I use pliers a lot more than other glass artists, but you know, it's faster. I mean, that is how I make glass do what I want. I don't know. Perhaps the pliers usage will fade with time. I just started making these. Last leg. And so I think it's about done. In a second, I will take this off of the punty stick. And then I'll go put it in the kiln. I'll append pictures of it hanging and sitting on a table so that you get to see how it came out. I really like it. Thanks for watching, guys.